Wait. Okay, hold on.
Yep, let's do that. Perfect.
I hope we can hear you.
Yes.
All right, so let's complete this. Everybody wins. When girls can stay in school. Everybody wins when girls can stay in school. Okay?
Yes.
All right. These are my objectives. By the end of this session, you should be able to understand the term gender equality. You should be able to identify obstacles to girls' access to education. And secondary education in particular. What would you like to be in future?
I want to be a medical doctor. I'd like to be a petrochemical engineer.
So when you are not able to complete your secondary education, what do you think would happen to your dream?
You won't be able to become the person you want to become in future.
So let's open our handout to page 13. When you compare girls and boys, who are going to school more? Boys and girls, who are going to school? Yes.
The boys.
Okay. Sub-Saharan Africa has the highest number of girls out of school. And they are denied the right to education. But what are some of the things that prevent you from going to school, especially the girl child?
Teenage pregnancy.
What causes teenage pregnancy?
Peer influence.
Okay, thank you, yes.
Financial problem.
You can't go to school because you wouldn't be able to get the things, your books, your uniform and other things, you can't be able to do it, afford them. So what's gender parity at all? When we say gender parity,
it is the equal number of men and women represented in a particular situation.
The equal number of men and women represented in a particular situation. Let's give her the wow clap.
Wow. Wow.